Well, good morning. I am at Stillwater Prairie Reserve. And the reason for this video, I have attached a video I produced for Macstock, for the virtual Macstock we had this year. And I wanted to share it with my audience, my community, whatever you want to call it, on my channel on YouTube. So what I've done is I've put this little prelude to it, and then you'll be able to watch the video. Now what the video is about, I'm trying to share how I use apps, three or four particular apps, to help me to identify birds and wildlife as I hike. So I want to share it here. If you find it boring, you don't have to watch it, but I hope you do enjoy it. Macstock happens every year. It's been virtual for the last 2 years. It'll be back to normal next year, and I'll put a link right up here. And you can go to that link if you're interested in going to Macstock. I think it's a great event. If you want to learn anything about the Mac, iPhone, iPad, it's a great place to go. I have spoke there before. I always go. I've gone every year that it's been there. It's been there for, this is year 7, counting the 2 virtuals, I think. But next year it'll be a 3-day event, and all the details will be at that link. Sign up to get the newsletter if you're interested. Thanks. Enjoy the video. Cartwright, and welcome to my office. I brought you along today while I hike at this beautiful location. This here is the Stillwater River in West Central Ohio. It's a scenic river. It's one of my favorite rivers in the state of Ohio. And this is the Stillwater Prairie Reserve. I brought you here today so that I can show you 2 things that are really important to me. Number 1, nature. I wanted to show you how I use these apps that I use when I'm hiking to enhance the hiking experience. Help familiarize with how I use those apps and help you see how it's actually done. I'll show you 3 apps primarily today. The first app I'm going to show you is related to identifying insects and bugs. In fact, it's got bugs in the name. The second and third app I'm going to show you are related to how I identify birds and how I use the iPhone coupled with these apps to not just identify the birds, but learn more about the birds. So that's what we're gonna do today. I hope you enjoy this. It's gonna be a great time. Okay, we've moved a little bit away from the river now. We have moved into this field of wildflowers, and this is one of my favorite spots for finding butterflies, large insects of a variety of types, and I really enjoy coming here because you never know what you're going to find. So I'm going to start with a little intro to how I use this app that I'm going to share with you here in a minute to help identify bugs. Now that may sound funny, but I have a love for taking pictures of bugs when I'm out in this area. Now, I don't do it, I'm not gonna come over to your house and take pictures of your bugs, but hopefully you don't have any. But that's what I'm here to show you today. So watch this next couple clips. I'll show you an example. There's some bugs right out here I saw. We're gonna get some pictures and at least one to show you how this works.
I'm gonna start the demo today with a piece of software called Picture Insect Bug Identifier. This app is amazing. You can feed it either a picture that you have in your library or some other source, or you can take a picture with your iPhone right into Picture Identifier and identify a bug. So here's a demo.
The first step is to snap a picture of your insect. I took a picture of this dragon hunter. And now I'm going to open the bug identifier, the insect identifier app, picture identifier app, and go in and from my camera roll, select that picture and pull it into the app. And then from there, you center the target in the viewfinder. You may want to enlarge it too. In my case, it filled the target. Then you click in to identify it, and bang, there it is, Dragon Hunter. I love how this app works. And a lot more information as you scroll down the screen. All right, I want to talk about a couple things before I continue. First thing I want to talk about is this particular app, Picture Insect Bug Identifier. One of the things I like about this app is the job it does in helping to give you information about the bugs you're looking at. So in the case of this Dragon Hunter, I'm going to show you some of the stuff that you see on the screen on your iPhone. So I'm going to show this. I use an iPhone 12 Pro Max as my iPhone, and I also shot most of this video with that. But you'll see what that looks like here on the screen. So I really like this tool for that functionality. The other thing I wanted to mention is I'm going to shoot all these pictures with my large camera. This is my DSLR. It's a Nikon, and I use a 150 to 600 millimeter lens, and that's what I shoot most of the birds with. So throughout this video, I'll be using that, and I should have mentioned that earlier. So one of the other apps I use a lot, I showed you here, it's called iBird Photo. iBird Photo is very, very powerful. I'm going to use it primarily in this video, in this demo, just to show you how I use it to identify birds from pictures or from pictures in my camera roll or pictures that I take live. Most of the time I use it is after I've hiked. I have a bird that I took a picture of. I want to know what the bird was, and I use the app to take a picture of it. But it also does some other really cool things. One of the really powerful things it does is it generates the sound of various birds. So I've used it actually in one particular case to call a bird, and the bird actually came to me, really dive bombed me and tried to get to me. And it turned out to be a great experience, and here's a picture of that bird. But what a great experience that was. So it does other things like give you a lot of information about the bird, it's how it nests, it's its habits, it takes you to a Wikipedia page about the bird. A whole variety of things that are really powerful, and it is my favorite app. So I'll show you a demo of that right here, right now. All right, the sun is really bright, so I don't know how well this is going to work. Right back there, there's a great blue herring. I'm going to put his picture here. You'll be able to see his picture, but what a beautiful bird. I don't need no apps to identify this bird. I'll run the app, iBird, which identifies the bird. And later on, I'll use that as an example of some of the ways I use iBird. But right there he is. I know what it is. And just a beautiful bird. So it's really sunny and bright today. We'll see how this goes. But what a beautiful sight. All right. Let's show you how iBird works. The first thing we're going to do is pull up iBird on your iPhone. Once you've pulled it up, then you're going to select that you want to identify a bird using the sleuth identifier. And it'll allow you to go into your library or take a picture and find that bird in the frame. And then you can center it and get it all lined up inside the frame on the sensor, on the detection, and then allow it to do it. And it'll give you a confidence level of how sure it is it's the bird that you're looking at. And then you can make a decision. You can open the whole iBird app then to study more details on the bird. It's quite an incredible app, one of my favorites. All right, so I wanted to take a few minutes and talk about another app that I use a lot, and that's called Merlin. Merlin is made by the Cornell Lab people, and it's a really interesting app that I really like to use. So I want to talk about that for a few minutes and what I do with that app. Now that app, if I'm going to show you on the side here, you'll see it. I'm looking at it on another phone here, but it'll do a few things that are really neat. It identifies birds, much like iBird Photo, but it also will allow you to get the sound of a bird and figure out what the bird is, identify the bird by its sound, which I find incredibly powerful. And so I'm going to show you on the screen here what it looks like. The app doesn't cost anything. You can get it for free. There are several libraries that you have to download to use it. If you're going to use it, I don't remember how many libraries, but I use one from the Midwest, one from the US, one from the Rocky Mountain area, the region. but you can download a variety of regions around the world, so not just in the States. And I'll show you a screen of that as well. But it's a powerful app. So I'm going to show you how you use that in some hiking I did here at the Stillwater Prairie Reserve. I hope you enjoy that. Talking very loud because I hear a bird in the distance, several of them actually, but I'm going to use the Merlin app to identify this bird and watch how this works. So the first thing you do is you start the app, and then what you do is you collect that you want to listen to the sound and identify by sound. Then it listens for a while and identifies all the birds that it can hear. If it hears more than one bird, it'll identify all the birds that are in the area. And then what happens with that is you can take that information and go look at the bird, look at the bird, see what it looks like, and help you try to find the bird, or at least know it's in the area. So this is how it works. Watch. Now what it said was that the bird it heard was a white-breasted nuthatch. So there's clearly a white-breasted nuthatch in the area. They do frequent this spot, so I've seen them here before. So let's see if we can find one. And if I do, I'll put the picture in, but I haven't seen one yet. I'm going to keep looking. Cool. But I want to show a contrast of two different butterflies that look almost identical, but the app helps to identify that one is a monarch, the other one's a viceroy. And if you look close to the wings, and I'll show you a picture here, there is a difference in the design of the wing, but you wouldn't know that just by looking from a distance. Now, if you watch a viceroy fly, they fly a little different flight path than the monarch does. And not too many people know that. A lot of people mistake viceroys for monarchs. So here's a picture of a viceroy. I'll use the insect identifier to identify it by its picture. And you'll see that, and then I'll show you the monarch. All right, the first thing we're going to do is open the app and pull in the picture of the butterfly that we're trying to identify. We select it and it goes through and identifies it as a viceroy. And that's basically all there is to that. The next one we want to do is pull in the picture for the monarch. And as you can see, there's no line across the back of the wing there. We pull it in the same way, right out of our camera roll, and get it centered. If it's not, you may want to magnify it to take up the whole area, identify it. It sees it's a monarch, a lot of information there about the monarch, and that's how it works. It's really pretty simple to use and works great. Well, that brings us to an end of the video. Of the demos, and I want to thank you for watching. I made some notes of some things I want to be sure and tell you here at the close of this video. So first comment is where I'm at now is in the corner of the park. This bridge behind me is a new bridge that joins this park to Maple Ridge, which is another park on the other side of the river. And it's really beautiful through there, a great walk, great hike, and we love this area and this park, as I've mentioned several times. So just want to say thank you for watching. I love spending time with nature. I love the time I've been able to spend here and sharing a little bit of my adventures out here with you. And I hope you found it useful in learning how these three apps work that we talked about today. So I actually recorded this video over several days. I didn't do it all at once, as you probably noticed. A couple days were cloudy, a couple days were clear. Today's another beautiful day. It's clear, it's chilly this morning. You would think it's fall, but it's really, really pretty out here today. So we covered three apps that I want to just summarize what we did. So the first app that we talked about was, it's called Picture Insect, and you can get it on the App Store. There is a subscription fee to use it, but it really is powerful and really does a great job. Second app we talked about was iBird Pro. iBird Pro is my favorite app for identifying birds and helping me to understand a lot about the birds that I see. I use it primarily at home after my hikes. So I'll go out, take a hike, I'll see a bird, I wanted to learn a little bit more about the bird, or I want to make sure I confirm that it's the right bird, I will use that app a lot of times after the fact to help me make sure I have the right bird. So that's iBird Pro. It also will allow you to generate the sounds of the birds and play those loud, which can be fun. You have to be careful that you don't create stress. You know, like I showed you that example where I called bird in, I wouldn't recommend doing that very often because it really is stressful for the bird. But I do use it occasionally for that particular species because of they're just fun to take photos of them when they come to see me. The last app we talked about was Merlin, and Merlin is free. Oh, iBird is not free. I put the cost on the board. I don't remember on the screen. I don't remember what the cost is. It's not a subscription, but it does have a fee. And then the last one we watched was Merlin. Merlin was great, and I hope you enjoy that app. It does a great job as well. So this video, this video is not about a product review. This is just a demo of these three apps and of my experiences. So I hope that it was helpful in that way and you treat it as that. Last thing I wanted to mention was I didn't get time to dive into plants. There are several apps on the App Store that are specifically targeted at plants. I do like to take pictures of wildflowers and landscape shots of fields of wildflowers and butterflies and everything you see. But I'm not really big on identifying plants. It's just not something I get excited about. But I take hikes with naturalists out here sometimes, and they get really excited about the flowers and the wildflowers. So I've used like iNaturalist and PlantSnap. And I have used those. They do a great job, and there's a bird flying by that just distracted me. But it's not something that I spend a lot of time on. So now it's your turn. This is your time to get out, spend some time with nature, find an app that you like, take some pictures of these beautiful creatures in nature, and share it with your friends. I blog at this blog. I'll put it up here, Tales.Photos. I put a picture up every day of the wildlife that I see. I also am on Twitter, Facebook, and all the social apps as Rick Cartwright. And you're welcome to look me up there. You can email me. My email will be here as well. Love to talk to anyone that wants to talk about these apps or anything related to photography of nature. It's a lot of fun, and it's what I do and enjoy doing so much. The last thing I have to share is, earlier in the video, we took a picture of a dragon hunter. Well, I found a very unique version of the dragon hunter that kind of has a fun take on life. Watch him. He's going to...